Argentina is witnessing massive mobilizations against the right-wing government of Mauricio Macri, demanding concrete measures to combat the socio-economic crisis in the country. On August 27th, thousands across Argentina took part in the 5th National March Against the Trigger-Happy. They mobilized against state violence with banners that said, "Enough of the trigger-happy police. Not a boy or a girl less, not a bullet more. The state is responsible." The mobilizations were called by the National March Against the Trigger Happy. The movement is comprised of the relatives of victims of reckless use of firearms. Trigger happy use of firearms is when security forces shoot at suspects of crimes, armed or not, irrespective of whether they have been judicially proven guilty of a crime or not. The Chocobar Doctrine resolution allows police to shoot without identifying themselves, shoot at the suspect's back, and kill with fewer restrictions. In 2015, the first set of marches were held in Buenos Aires to denounce cases of trigger-happy gun violence led by the relatives of Ismael Sosa, a 24-year-old boy who was found dead in the embalse Rio Tercero Lake in January 2015. He had left home to attend a concert in Villa Rumipal and never came back. This is the fifth national march to denounce state violence, which has left around 6,500 young people dead since 1983, which amounts to one person every 21 hours.
Ni un pibe menos, ni una piba menos, ni una bala más, el Estado es responsable.
The number of cases have increased during the current right-wing government of Cambiemos party, led by President Mauricio Macri. On August 28th, meanwhile, another demonstration took place. Under the slogan of emergency to confront hunger, more than 250,000 workers from different sectors, left-wing political parties, along with members of several social, human rights, women, and students' organizations, flooded the streets in Argentina demanding implementation of the Food Emergency Act, extension of social emergency measures, an increase in the supplementary social salary, and a 40% increase in the budget for lunch and snacks in schools. The protesters also demanded the cessation of suspension of labor programs, a better budget for the popular economy sector, along with a bonus of 2,000 pesos for the popular economy workers. An increase in the minimum pension and retirement benefits has also been called for. The mobilization was carried out as a part of the National Struggle Day, called for by various unions and organizations, and with the support of different movements in the country. Macri's economic measures have led the nation to its worst recession in history. More than 50% of the Argentine population is severely affected by the economic crisis facing the country.
Esta situación económica y social en la que estamos viviendo tiene nombre y apellido. Mauricio Macri y el Fondo Monetario Internacional.
The social and economic conditions in the country are continuously deteriorating due to the devaluation of the national currency, increasing unemployment, poverty, homelessness, food insecurity, and inflation, the majority of the Argentine working class finds itself in a daily struggle trying to make ends meet. The setback Macri received in the primary election is a clear reflection of the people's anger towards his government and the neoliberal anti-people policies implemented by him.